Hi, I'm Florian Kohler. Today I'm going to teach you two of the most popular pool games, 8-ball and then 9-ball. Let's start with the most famous game of all, 8-ball. So in order to play 8-ball, you're going to need a cue ball, which is usually placed behind the imaginary line right here. I would usually take about half the table there. And then you're going to need 15 balls in a triangle. As many of you know, the 8-ball is always in the middle, right here. And then for the rest, the balls are pretty much just spread randomly. I heard a lot of things when people try to put them in a certain order. You really don't have to. This is just 8-ball in the middle and no line of the same solid as the stripes. Again, you're going to try to sort of find a virtual line which goes in the middle here and put the 5-ball straight in that line. Once you're there, all you got to do is basically push the balls together like this. And you're going to make sure when you remove the rack that the 3, the 5 and the 13 are together touching. Once it's there, then you gently push it back and remove the triangle. Now the good thing on the Cornilleau table is it's got a nice little feature when you can put the rack under the table, nobody sees it, and you're pretty much ready to start, break and play 8-ball. Guy just broke, table is open, and I'm ready to take my first shot. So let's cover how to play 8-ball exactly. I made a couple solids. In world rules, it's basically open table, meaning I can still pick solid or stripes. But for most amateur, I like to pick this set of rules, meaning it's take what you make. So if I potted solids on the break, I'll have to keep going on solids. So that being said, in both set of rules, you have to make all the stripes or the solids, finish your 8-ball to win the game. The only ball that people usually have to call is the 8-ball, meaning if I'm on the 8-ball, I have to call the pocket, which would be in this case the corner pocket, for example. But if it goes somewhere else, then it would be a loss of the game. Let's talk briefly about a legal hit and foul. So if I'm playing on the 7, for example, but you know I miscue something and I hit a stripe, that results in a foul. That means my opponent is gonna get ball in hand anywhere on the table, meaning you can put the cue ball anywhere it wants. The only time you do not have ball in hand anywhere on the table is after the break, meaning if I break and I scratch or if I broke and the cue ball went out, I have ball in hand, but behind that line. This is pretty much the only thing. And from there, all you have to do is basically play and have fun. Let's now talk about 9-ball. So in order to play 9-ball, you'll need a cue ball and 9 balls. The cue ball is gonna be set behind that line, imaginary line once again here, and then the 9 balls are gonna be shaped as a diamond. It'll be balls 1 through 9, so it'll be 8 solids and 1 stripe. In order to put this together, all you make sure is that the 9 is in the middle and the 1 is up top. Usually you have to make the 2 in the back 2 rows for pros, but in our case here, it doesn't really matter too much. I also have a diamond-shaped triangle that is also going with the Cornilleau table when you buy it. So now we're just gonna make sure everything is freezing against, just gently pull it up, and we're pretty much good to break and see what happens. We just broke, the table is now open. So I made the 3-ball and I made the 1-ball. So what it does, it basically gives me a chance to keep going at the table. The rules for 9-ball is pretty simple. You have to always hit the ball or the lowest number first and then keep going gradually in numerical order. So in our case here, I'll be the 2 first, then the 4, then the 5, then the 6, then 7, 8, and 9. Whoever makes the 9 wins the game, no matter how many balls you made before. You could have made all 8 balls, but if you miss the 9 and the opponent makes the 9, he wins the game. So you have to be pretty careful, and it's a lot of, you gotta pretty much try to play position as well as you can. 9-ball is also a very aggressive game because flukes count, meaning if I try to make the 2 in this middle but it goes in this middle, then it still counts and I just keep going and go with it. Now it's also aggressive because you can also combo and carom the 9-ball, meaning let's say if I were to hit the left side of 2, send the 2-ball into the 9 and the 9 goes in the corner, I win the game. The same thing if I were to carom, meaning if I hit the cue ball, cut this 2 and then the cue ball goes and hit the 9 and make the 9 in the corner, also win the game. 9-ball also has what we call the 3-foul rule, meaning that if you foul more than 3 times, you also lose the game. A foul just like 8 ball is when you do not touch the intended ball or the ball at the right lowest number. So in this case, if I do not miss, if I do not hit the two but hit another ball first, I'll be a foul and my opponent gets ball in hand and he's got to put it anywhere he wants on the table. That also works after the break. That's pretty much all you got to know for 9 ball. All it is now, and you just got to make balls and have fun.